Hey guys, welcome to What Is It Wednesday? This one's a big one this week. There's a lot of thinking that needs to be done. So hopefully everybody sort of knows how to identify the ABC of any scenario. And remember, under the A umbrella, we've got MOs, we've got SDs, we've got prompts. Under the B column, we've got the behavior, anything associated with the measurable and observable piece. And then of course, in the C column, we've got our consequences. Very, very important to first identify the behavior, right? So the behavior in this case, hopefully everybody got that part right initially, which is ordering extra sauce. So why does she order extra sauce? Because she likes it. It makes her food taste better. So if the reinforcement is better tasting food, then the MO has to sort of be the converse of that. It has to be the deprivation of that extra flavor of that sauce. So MOs and consequences are going to have that sort of yin and yang relationship. Whatever you're deprived of is what's going to be more reinforcing for you. Now, if you're deprived of flavor and sauce or whatever, deprived of anything, you're gonna seek out all of the things that signal the availability of that thing you're deprived of. So in this case, it's obviously the attendant who takes her order, who has access to the extra sauce. But again, the SD, it's not that it evokes your behavior. The SD tells you what behavior to do in order to get a specific reinforcer. But you're not gonna do any of that unless you have that state of deprivation, which is the MO. So in this case, the SD is the attendant. The behavior necessary to get the extra sauce is just saying, hey, can I have some extra sauce? And of course, the contingency is you ask and you shall hopefully receive. So that's how we figure out our MO, SD, behavior, and reinforcement in these types of scenarios. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you next time.